Hi guys, it's Kiyako here, back with another character build slash speed build. This is a build of a cat lady and her apartment. Quite possibly my future? I don't know, we'll see. I currently have a cat, I love my cat. I don't currently have as many cats as this woman does. But you know, honestly, sometimes I dream about having an enormous amount of cats and it's a nightmare, but it's also a dream, so. Do with that information what you will. Let me know if any of you guys have cats and if you feel like this is at all, you know, relatable to the cat owning experience, especially when it comes to looking at her apartment. I took some liberties with how easy it is to own a cat. We'll talk about that more later on as we look at me build it. But right now I'm putting together Serena. So this is Serena Patel. She is absolutely freaking beautiful. I think she's so cute. And for her character, what I imagined is that she's probably just fresh out of college and she has 7 cats, which is a lot of cats, like an enormous, enormous amount of cats. Like, I love my cat, but even one cat is a little bit much. Cats are amazing. I love cats. But she has 7 cats. They're all different breeds. They're all different types. To be totally honest with you guys, I didn't put like a lot of work into like customizing each cat. I kind of just like chose from the breed menu and just like tweaked little things here and there. But I mean, usually when I play gameplay in The Sims and I have like my Sims like own a pet, like an animal, I tend to just kind of do that. I usually just pick a breed, and because like the EA team or the Sims team made like the breed you know, default dogs and cats so freaking cute, I usually don't feel like any need to change them, to be totally honest. So usually I don't. So in this case, you'll see me later on picking out different breeds of cats, and I just kind of tweak like their eyes and like their whiskers and stuff. But other than that, we're not gonna like go into crazy like customization of these cats for like all 7 of them. That's so much. But like I said, this is Serena. Isn't she beautiful? I love this hair on her. I recently used this hair in another video. I think this is from, you know, I'm not even gonna guess. I wanna say I wanna say the Eco Lifestyle Pack, but I'm not sure. I know it's from an EA pack. It's not a custom content hair, but I think it's so freaking cute. Anyways, I'm putting together her outfit here. This is a shirt I actually downloaded like right before I started playing, and it's so cute. I love it. The color palette is perfect for her apartment, which you will see later on. She fits in perfectly with it. She's absolutely lovely. Well, let's get back to her character. I'm praising her too much for how she looks, but she has a brain too. I think she's incredibly, incredibly intelligent. I imagine that perhaps maybe she works or, well, she's recently out of college, so I imagine maybe she's either, you know, studying to go to medical school, or she is interning for NASA. So, I mean, I know those are very two different paths, but I don't know. I couldn't really decide if I saw her more as a doctor or more as like a space scientist engineer person. Let me know what you think. What do you think Serena does? Let me know in the comments down below. I gave her these platform shoes, which are so cute. I freaking love platform shoes, but I don't think I can walk in them very well. I need to learn to walk in them because platforms are coming back, you guys, and I really want to get on that trend. I love platforms. But as you can see, she loves animals. She loves her cats. She's definitely, you know, a cat lady. And this is her first cat. We're going to make him this cute little black cat. He's so adorable. His name is Shadow, which is a very common cat name, especially for black cats, I think. But you know, it's still a cute name. I think I knew a cat named Shadow once, but I can't recall in what context I knew that cat. But anyways, this is Shadow. He's very cute. I imagine that he's kind of like, I mean, we're gonna get into like cat characterizations here, which are obviously not realistic, but just for the fun of the game, I imagine Shadow's kind of like the leader of the cat clan. Like, he's more of the alpha male. Like, you can see he's clever. He's very, you know, I honestly don't remember what traits I gave him, but he's more of like the leader type. Our next cat is named Princess. She is very fluffy, spoiled, lazy. She's, you know, she's a princess. She expects to be treated like a princess. I think she's so cute. I think, you know, when I was a kid, I used to think these kind of like the fluffy, like really round faced cats like this were so ugly. Just being honest, you guys, but now I actually think they're really cute, and I don't know why. I think there's something about their little pudgy faces are just so adorable. My cat is not this fluffy. My cat's a short hair, but he's still very, very cute. And this is Princess. And our next cat is, I'm trying to remember who our next cat is. I don't quite recall. Let's see. Our next cat is... The anticipation is killing me. I don't quite recall. I don't remember it. I won't know until we pick it out and I remember. I think it's a... Let's see. Is it one of these? Oh, it's a... Isn't it a bald cat? Yeah. It's a bald cat. I don't know. What are these called? Sphinxes. They're so cute. Again, it's another one of those cat breeds that I used to hate when I was a kid, but now as an adult, I think they're so cute. I don't know why. I've never been able to see a sphinx in real life or touch one, so I can't really imagine what they feel like to hold other than, like, a sack of skin, which is, like, oddly appealing to me now. I don't know why. I think they're so cute. Like, I don't know. Something about hairless cats is so unique, and I feel like... So chic, too. Kind of Gucci, aren't they? I don't know. But this is... What is her name? Granny. Yeah, because she's an older cat. She's, like, more... she's probably, you know, she's probably Serena's first cat. So she's definitely the oldest out of the bunch. Our next cat is this... Let's see. Is it Tabby? Yeah, this Tabby. Okay, so this Tabby is our younger one. He's very adventurous. His name is Indiana, obviously named after Indiana Jones because of his adventurous personality. And I love his stripes. He's so freaking cute. And his little whiskers, his yellow collar. Oh my goodness. I'm dying. These cats are so adorable. I used to not really be like a cat person. I always said like, oh, I'm a dog person. I'm a dog person. I'm a dog person. And then I got a cat and I was like, wow. I'm a cat person. I definitely understood a lot better after I got a cat, and then I was just like, wow, I'm a cat person. Like, I used to not get, like, watching, like, cat videos online. Like, I wasn't, like, they were cute, but I wasn't really, like, oh my god, so cute! But now that I have a cat, for some reason, that part of my brain, like, activated, and now whenever I see a cute cat video online, I'm like, oh my god! And I just, like, I freak out. And this is our next cat. What is this cat? Oh, Mustard. This is Mustard, which I think is an adorable name for a cat. Mustard is fluffy, he's lazy, he's a glutton. He's Mustard. He's cute. Our next cat. Who comes after Mustard? I'm quite... you know, honestly, I never remember the Sims that I build for some reason. I never remember their names. I think this is a Siamese, right? Is that what this breed is called? I don't quite recall, but he's cute. this is... Ooh, what is this cat's name? I'm trying to remember. I don't remember. Tell me this cat's name. Past me. She's friendly. Oh, Sweetie. That's what her name is. I just remember that. I named her Sweetie because I gave her like a very friendly, talkative trait. So I figured that she's the kind of cat who like loves meeting new people. She goes to the door and she meows at new people. And yeah, that's why she's called Sweetie, is because she's such a sweet cat and she's very social with people. Our next cat and our final cat is Sweetie's little kitten daughter. For a second I was gonna make it another Sphinx and gonna be the kitten of Granny, but instead I just made her the kitten of Sweetie. I don't know why I made that decision, but I did. So she is a Sweetie's daughter, and she's obviously freaking adorable. You know, I've never had a kitten before. My current cat, I got him off the streets when he was like one. So he was like fully grown, right? Like he was a big cat. And I always like... I don't know. I always think about what it would have been like to see him as a kitten, you know? Like, I would love to see my current cat as a kitten. I feel like I missed out on those days of him growing up and being new to the world. I don't know. Maybe that's just me. The kittens are so freaking cute. And this one especially is so, so, so cute. This is Dora, because she's an explorer. And now we are moving on to Serena's apartment. Now, I have no idea how Serena managed to find an apartment in New York City that allowed her to have seven cats. I mean, that landlord must be very, very chill. And or she had to pay like huge pet fees, because I know we had to pay like a pet fee to keep our cat in our apartment. So that's a thing. So maybe Serena's got some money on her and that's how she can provide for all these cats. But she lives in a relatively large apartment for a single person, especially in New York City. But, you know, with seven cats, it probably isn't that big. It's a one bedroom apartment, but she has enough space for, I think, everything she needs. Right now I'm putting together her bedroom. So the vibe I was kind of going with, you know, honestly, I don't know how to describe it. It's very, you can see by the color palette I'm going for already, it's very soft and a little bit pastel-y. And I also bring in like a lot of wood and wood tones and more like, I don't know what the word is. I don't know what this aesthetic is called. Just let me know if you guys know what this aesthetic is called. But I really like how her apartment turns out, particularly the living room, I think is really cute. But we're putting together her bedroom right now. So like I said in the beginning of this video, if you are a cat owner, there may be things in this video that you're like, that's not realistic, you know, for various reasons. Like, for example, like when I put a flower vase on a coffee table, that's not super realistic if you have a cat, at least if you have a cat like mine, because he will jump on that coffee table and knock over that flower vase. So there's little things here and there that's a little bit like, but you know what? If this was like a super realistic cat build, there'd be like hairballs everywhere and everything would be covered in like hair and it would be a little bit of a nightmare. So we're just gonna say this is like a cat lady's apartment in a dream world, in a utopia. But as you can see, I already put some cat stuff in a room. I put some scratching post stuff, some various beds. There's a little cat bed right by the left side table on her bed. So she needs a lot of different beds, a lot of different food bowls and litter boxes, because she's got seven cats and they don't really like to share, so she's got a lot of stuff going on. This is her wardrobe, put in a mirror, and then we're gonna put in some paintings. Not all the artwork is like cat related, but I tried to make like as much of it possible cat related, because Serena, definitely obsessed with cats. Right above her bed, she has that big portrait of a cat. Maybe that's Shadow, because that's like a little black cat there, so maybe that's like a picture of Shadow or something. I mean, favoritism much, but anyways, choosing other paintings, let's see. Because you can see me, you know, a lot of this video is going to be me scrolling through all my painting swatches looking for, like, cats. Because I definitely wanted, like, a lot of cat content, you know, just to be on theme. But, you know, it's very, very cute in the end. So what I do on this wall is I actually create, like, a little, what's the word? Like a shelving playground, I guess? I don't know what you would call this. It's like, you know, when people put, like shelves on their walls for the cats to like go up and climb and stuff. Like, I know there's businesses that do this, that build like custom shelving for cats and stuff. We actually have one in our house. It's not like a custom one that like we bought from a special company. We just went to Home Depot and bought some shelves and put it up, because we wanted our cat to have like a place to go up on the walls and like, you know, be high up, because apparently cats like being high up and like looking down and like, you know, being sneaky and stuff. So we set up this whole shelving thing for him, and then he doesn't use it. He doesn't use it. He's supposed to use it, because that's what I was told, that the cats like that stuff, but I guess he's not that kind of cat. I mean, he'll go up there when we like throw treats up there and stuff, but other than that, he doesn't really use it by himself, so. This cat drives me crazy, but I love him. Anyways, this is the living room. Very, very cute. You know, good luck with that very light pink couch. She's gonna get, you know, scratches and fur and a lot of stuff all over that couch. And then we put in these cute little chairs. You can kind of see the aesthetic coming together now. It's kind of like cutesy, a little bit modern, a little bit traditional. I mean, those conflict, but I was trying to like go for, you know, just kind of like a cute look in general, you know? And I think I was successful in that. I think this is a pretty cute apartment, especially in the color palette, you know? It's very, very cute. Anyways, this corner here is going to be her office space, since there wasn't really like room in her bedroom for her to like have a desk or anything. So I gave her this L desk, and we're gonna decorate this whole desk with a whole bunch of things. Like I said, let me know what you think that she does for a living, or like what she's pursuing. You know, maybe she's trying to be a vet. That would probably make a lot of sense. Okay, forget what I said earlier about the doctor stuff and the NASA stuff. She's trying to be a vet. She's going to vet school. That's what we're gonna go with, because I don't know why I didn't think of that before, but it makes a lot of sense now. Anyways, I decorated her whole desk there, which is very cute. I really like how that desk turns out, especially the little printer on the side. That's a very cute printer. My current printer is a nightmare printer. Always breaks and never works. Ugh. Anyways, you can see she has a little kitty calendar there, which is so cute. She loves cats, obviously. She has a vacuum on hand, ready to go, because every day she's gotta vacuum all that cat hair out of her carpet. I'm gonna put, what do we put over here? I think like a little wardrobe. Yeah, a little wardrobe and a little mirror, I believe. Oh, a little cat portrait. Perfect, love that. And then we're gonna put in some books up there. Again, not really realistic. If this was my cat, he would jump on that in a second and knock over all those books. He loves doing that, especially in the morning time. And I think it's because he likes waking me up so that he gets my attention. So yeah. Anyways, we are putting in, what else are we putting in? Oh, I have this little neon cat sign. I put that by her desk because I absolutely needed to use it, because it was so cute. And then we're gonna set up another little shelving playground. I thought about the shelf going all the way across the top, but it looked a little strange, so I just kept it in that right corner. But it is very, very cute. Can cats in The Sims jump on shelves? I don't actually know. I play The Sims all the time, but I don't do enough gameplay stuff. So there's a lot of mechanics about the game that I just don't know. So that's my dirty little secret. But she has a piano. So Serena's not just about cats. She has other passions too. She also plays the piano. We have a little keyboard in our house as well. And... if anyone else, again, if you have a cat and you have a keyboard, you'll know they'll love to jump on that keyboard and cause all sorts of noise and sound. Anyways, this is her kitchen. Very, very cute kitchen. Gonna put in a little kitchen table so she has a place to sit down and eat. And then we're gonna put in some flowers. Again, cats would probably knock it off. And then she has all 7 food bowls lined up against the wall here because they don't really like to share food bowls, is what I have heard from people who have multiple cats, is that you have to feed them like separately, which makes sense, right? So they all have their own little food bowl, and all the food bowls are obviously in the color palette. And then back here is her little laundry room because she absolutely needed a laundry room because, you know, you gotta wash your clothes all the time. You gotta get all that cat hair out. Get the cat smells out. So she has her own little laundry room. And maybe this is like also like her peace room, like a room where she'll go and sit just to get like a few minutes of like meditation and peace away from all her animals. Cause you know, she loves her cats, but sometimes she needs alone time. So maybe she locks herself in the laundry room. but this is the bathroom, which is a relatively large bathroom, actually. I actually really like this bathroom. And in that back corner there, we put in a litter box. There will be other litter boxes because what I've also heard is that you shouldn't, like, make your cats share litter boxes. Like, you can, but apparently it can cause a lot of conflict and they don't really like it. So apparently it's suggested that you have, like, separate litter boxes for all your cats. And that being said, I don't actually put like 7 litter boxes in this build because that would be like take up way too much space. So there's like 3 or 4 litter boxes like spread out throughout. So I imagine the cats kind of like communally use the litter boxes, I guess. And this is her dining room, which she probably doesn't use a lot. I don't imagine that she has a lot of guests over, not because of the cats. I just kind of imagine Serena more as like maybe a little bit of a wallflower, you know, like she's a little bit of a loner. She's single, but I think she really likes it. I think she loves being alone. I think she loves the single life. I think she loves being independent and doing her own thing and hanging out with her cats. That's just kind of what I imagine for her character. And then we're gonna put in that little painting, put stuff on the wall, and we're just finishing up the entryway here. I'm gonna put in a little wardrobe, a suitcase. Maybe she is going on a trip or something. And then we're gonna put in, let's see, a little side table. I really like that side table for some reason. I really like the color of it, it's so cute. And then we're gonna put in a little clothing rack. Yeah, like a little, what's this called, like a wall hanger. And then she's gonna hang up her scarves, her jacket. She has 2 scarves. I don't know, that's a lot of scarves. I don't think I own any scarves. I own like the silk scarves you put in your hair, but I don't own like wool. Oh no, I do actually, that's a lie. I have some, I just remembered. Okay, I'm also a scarf lady, apparently. I just don't wear them that much, but I do have them. Anyways, decorating this shelf here, she has a lot of books, because she's a very intelligent lady, she loves to read. I'm gonna put in, let's see. Okay, now we're doing the outside balcony area. So this is, okay, here's the thing about this. If this was realistic and you had a lot of cats and you want your cats to go outside, she would probably need to put up some sort of like net or like fencing over like the railing. And like up, you know what I mean? So like the cats can like jump like off the balcony, because they probably would, you know? I read something once about how cats like aren't a really good judge of height. So sometimes like even though they're really high up, they can think that they can jump, but they can't. I don't know if that's true. Who told me that? Did TikTok tell me that? I don't know. I read that somewhere. Anyways, I just don't want her cats to jump off this balcony and die. So, like pretend that there's a net up there. Like I did look around briefly and try to find something that would work, but I really couldn't. So just pretend. But as you can see, there's a little seating area out here so that Serena can chill out here. There's a toy box for, you know, toys for her cats. There's some litter boxes on the side there. So they have a place to go outside here. And I also imagine that she trains her cats a little bit. So there's that little hoop and the little things the cats run through. So this is Serena and that's Mustard having fun in their house. And then we're gonna go through the screenshots of the home. I really like how this turned out. I think I did a cat lady house a a long time ago, I think. You know, honestly, like, the build, like, if a build that I did was longer than a month ago, I don't remember it. I just have really bad memory, I think. Especially when it comes to The Sims, I think, because I build all the time. So, if I did this before, I honestly don't remember. I think I did, because I vaguely remember, like, doing cat stuff. But I think I like this one better, even though I don't really remember the last one. I just had more fun, you know, putting in all this cat stuff. And now that I have a cat, I feel like I really understand cats more. That being said, there's a lot of things here that probably wouldn't work if you had a cat. Like, they would chew on those ruffles on that bed, for sure. But yeah. Anyways, if you have a cat, please let me know. Let me know their name, especially if it's a funny name. I love cats with funny names. And let me know what you think of this apartment in terms of a cat owner's perspective. Anyways, oh, really quick. I'm running a giveaway. It's ending tomorrow, so please check out the link down below. Check out the other video. And yeah, as always, thank you so, so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.